Umbraco is a very flexible CMS, and you can customize it to suit your specific needs. Of course, to customize, you will need to do a bit of development and familiarize yourself with the ASP.NET framework as well as other Microsoft technologies. My name is Sophie, and throughout this chapter, I will show you how you can create a custom form on your website, a form that can be used to add articles to an articles collection within that website. We will be covering a lot of ground, and in this introduction video, you can learn more about what's coming up. Umbraco CMS is built using C# and the Microsoft-based infrastructure ASP.NET. One of the core concepts that you need to know about and understand when building custom sites with Umbraco is MVC. This chapter you've just started watching is called Surface Controllers. The controllers part is actually what the C stands for in MVC. The others are models and views. Now, the whole idea with MVC is that the controller handles a request by working with the model to perform actions or retrieve data. The controller will also pick which view to use and tell it which model it should use for presenting the data. This all results in a web page rendered by the view, and this page is based on the data in the model. So, the model handles the data, the view handles how the data is shown, and the controller, well, it controls the request and makes sure the correct data is served by the correct view. To follow along in this chapter, it is recommended that you have a bit of MVC knowledge. In the next chapter, I'll tell you more about those recommendations. For now, with the very basics painted out, let's take a look at what I have in store for you in this chapter. As mentioned, we'll be creating a custom form that will allow the website visitors to add a new article to the articles collection. This here is the site that we'll be working on. The article collection lives up here. Not a lot of articles has been added at the moment, but our submission form should change that. And then over here, we have our submission form. Right now, it's made up entirely of static HTML. And if we try to submit something, we'll just say test article in the title here. Scroll down and submit it. The data is collected and added to the URL, as you can see up here. But nothing is really done with it. It's just sitting there waiting to be picked up, perhaps by something like a surface controller. The idea here is to create a new view for this form, and we'll also be creating a model to determine the type of data that we want the visitors to be able to add through the form. Finally, we'll create a controller, a surface controller, that will handle all the data collected from this form, put it into a new article, and then at the very end, also publish the article in the articles collection. Here's a quick look at the agenda. I'll start out by introducing you to service controllers. What are they and what can they be used for? Then we'll create the model for the data in our form. We'll move on to setting up the view. Then it's time to build the service controller. With all those three main components in place, we'll move on to creating content. And then to creating media. And with that, we'll have a full functioning article submission form on our website. In the next part, we'll go a bit further and we'll look into adding validation, a more friendly user experience, and we'll also look into how the form can be extended with other properties. As you can see, we've got a lot of ground to cover. Before we move on though, I've made a short list of prerequisites to ensure you get the most out of this chapter. First up, I'll be using Visual Studio to work on the website. It provides us with a lot of useful features and functionalities to aid us in the work we'll be doing. If you want to follow along with what I'm doing, you can find and download the project from the documentation page associated with this video. There you will also find some useful information about the project that we'll be using. You are of course welcome to use whichever project or website you want for this tutorial. Alright, and that's it. Now, let's get started. Head on over to the next video to learn more about surface controllers.